Hi, I'm Kelly Richdale. I'm a senior advisor at SandboxAQ and an executive fellow at the World Economic Forum.
Hi, my name is Freeke Heijman. I'm founder and CEO of Heijman Consultancy, which has started this summer. And before that, I ran the National Quantum Initiative in the Netherlands, also co-chairing the Global Future Council on Quantum Economy of the World Economic Forum.
So Freeke, this is definitely not your first Davos rodeo. Tell us what you've been doing with the forum.
Well, it's my third Davos actually, and every year is different. So the first time I was invited as an expert, so I was in the Congress Center talking in all kinds of panels on quantum computing, because that was kind of the next big thing on the block, and they wanted someone to share a little bit on what it was. And already then I was part of this Global Future Council on Quantum Economy, where I actually met Jack Hillary as well, your CEO, Sandbox CEO. So I have been involved with the forum for a couple of years now, and Davos is of course a highlight, but it's definitely not the only thing that's going on. Because in essence, there are all kinds of initiatives and consortia and communities that come together and launch new initiatives. For instance, with a couple of friends from the forum, we are now producing a documentary on quantum computing, because it's the year of quantum this year. It's 100 years anniversary of quantum mechanics. So we want to bring it to a big audience, so have it streamed on a big streaming platform such as Netflix or HBO. And other things, well, we have been working together, for instance, on the blueprint for the quantum economy. That's because we don't want the divide between the global south and the north to increase. So you see a lot of northern western countries having their own quantum program. It has to do with education, with R&D, with setting up ethical and legal programs for quantum computing. And we also want other countries to do the same in South America, in Asia, in Africa. And that's where we work together to build this blueprint that we help other countries do the same.
Yeah, so Sandbox co-wrote with the forum, the Quantum Economy Blueprint, talking about how, as Freeke said, we can ensure that there are access, open innovation around the quantum economy, and particularly in areas, either geographically or in certain industrial areas, gender diversity, where we can ensure that the quantum divide can be reduced. Do you see areas where Europe or America are getting it right in terms of providing access, not just to quantum, but to other technologies like AI, whether that's around education, whether that's around an openness to collaborate?
Well, I'm a little bit pessimistic, to be honest, because of the geopolitical developments that we see. And you see both Europe but also America just withdrawing a little bit in their own geographies and putting themselves first, so to say. And I think that's a threat for what we have been trying to achieve. And that's why I also think gatherings as we have here in Davos are so important, because here the whole world comes together. And although there are certain tensions, and we all know it's getting difficult, we do have to stay open and stay collaborative.
Well, I think in some of the areas also from a societal perspective around the implementation of new technologies, there are so many opportunities, but there are also dangers that come out with the AI and the quantum revolution. And where do you see most of the opportunities coming?
Well, I think the applications both for AI and for quantum, where I see the most promise is, for instance, material science, drug discovery, optimization problems. So there's a lot to gain there, also climate modeling. So things that we really don't have an answer to yet, and to find that answer. So that's where I see a lot of opportunities. I think the threats, well, the threat of AI, I think it's clear, of course, with virtual fake and what is not fake, and what it does with all our children, so to say, social media, etc. So that's a bit of a threat. And for quantum, if there's a quantum computer with a certain amount of qubits, that will be able to hack the cryptography that we are using today. And we are not sure yet when that will happen, but that it will happen, be it in 5, 6, 10 years, we need to prepare. So already now we need to transform to post-quantum cryptography. So that's very important.
So we've talked a bit about quantum computers, but there are also quantum methods that can be applied to today's AI. So as you know, SandboxAQ, A stands for AI, Q stands for quantum, and we're using ground-based modeling with a knowledge of quantum mechanics to inform machine learning and AI for what we call large quantitative models, whereby we can bring around, we can bring about new techniques and solutions around drug discovery, new materials modeling, etc., without waiting for the quantum computer. Where do you see this tech convergence between AI and quantum going? What do you predict for the future around this?
Yeah, well, I think it's getting more and more important. So SandboxAQ is doing great work on that. But we see it more like quantum algorithms helping machine learning algorithms to improve. So also in France, there have been certain examples already proven that it works, that certain machine learning techniques can be improved by using quantum algorithms. So I think that's a very important new field of research and development that we will see already hit the market already now, as SandboxAQ is proof of.
So what do you predict this year in terms of technology developments? There's quite a few geopolitical changes going on, as you mentioned. What do you see as, what is your prediction for this year?
Well, I think we will have a few very nice achievements technologically. So last year we had the Willow, Google announcing their Willow chip. So I think we'll see a few of that kind of, you know, breakthroughs for fault tolerance and also for quantum machine learning. So a few of those breakthroughs that will give us a little bit of optimism also in this geopolitical world that, well, we have to see where that goes.
Do you think today's policymakers, C-suite boards, are as technology aware as they need to be in terms of both the innovation potential of the new technologies, but also some of the threats around cybersecurity?
I think not yet. I think there's a lot of missionary work that needs to be done, and that's also something we pick up within the forum. Because, the advancements, they go really fast. We've seen with AI how fast the developments goes. And policymakers, they lack the technical expertise, so they need to be made aware of what's going to happen and what the possibilities are, and also what they need to do to play their role, because there's an important role to play for legislation and governance of these technologies as well.
Excellent. Thank you so much. Always a joy to see you in Davos.
Yeah. Thanks, Kelly.